Hello there again, I'm Mr. True. I want to talk to you again about finding equations of lines. Unlike the other day though, instead of using one point and a slope or 2 points, this time we're going to be given a point and then an equation of another line, or at least some information about another line. So let's first make sure we completely understand the idea of parallel lines and or slopes and perpendicular slopes. Here we have a diagram of a white line. It crosses through the origin, and its slope is 1/3. And on the blue line here, I've got a parallel line. Now, why are these two lines parallel, besides the fact that they look really similar? Well, this line, to get from this point to this point, you have to go up 1 and over 3. So this blue line has a slope of 1/3. Just like the white line does. If I count that out, to get from this point to this point, it's up 1 and over 3. So both of these lines are going through or have the exact same slope. Now they do have different y-intercepts. So since we're talking about equations of lines, let's see, I want to point this over here. This white line has a slope of 1 over 3, again, up 1 and over 3, and when you're writing in slope-intercept form, it's y equals m, which is the slope, 1/3 x plus b. Now, b is your y-intercept, and this line's crossing through the origin, so your y-intercept is 0, or y equals 1/3 x. Now, the blue line that's parallel, we can see crosses the y-axis. That's the y-axis that goes straight up and down. At 1, 2, 3. So y value or y-intercept is at 3. So this blue line's equation is y equals 1/3 x, same slope because they're parallel, and we counted it out. But now my y-intercept is 3, so we have y equals 1/3 x plus 3. Now let's see what it looks like if we're just given information and not a graph. Okay. We're going to find a line that is parallel to 3x plus 2y equals 10 and goes through 4/6. Okay. The other day, I talked about slope-intercept form of a line. That's y equals mx plus b. You have general form or standard form, which is ax plus by plus c equals 0. And then you have what we're going to be using, which is point-slope form for the information given. Point-slope form. Point-slope form tells you what you need to write the equation of a line. You need a point, which we have right here, and a slope. Well, unlike the other day, I'm not just giving you the slope. So why I need to use this equation of this line to come up with the slope? That is why the equation of this line is given to us, so that we can find the slope we need to fill in the rest of this information. Well, this is in almost general form. Some books may call the standard form. I cannot look at this and tell what the slope is because the y is not by itself. So I need to work this out. I need to get the 3x over to the right-hand side. I need to get the 2 away from the y, and when I have y equals mx plus b, then I've got the slope. I'll be able to look at it and tell. So I'm going to move this 3x over to the other side with subtraction. That bothers me. It looks like a division sign, so I'm going to get rid of this. And we have 2y equals negative 3x plus 10. I want to get y by itself, so I'm going to divide everything by 2 and get y equals negative 3/2 x plus 10 divided by 2 is not 10, it's equal to 5. The only purpose, when a book gives you a point and another line, the only reason why that line is given to you so you can figure out the slope. Well, I have the slope now. My slope is negative 3/5, 3/2. If I want a parallel line, I'm going to use this slope the way it is. If I want a perpendicular line, well, perpendicular lines have opposite reciprocal slopes. I would have to flip this and change the sign. but I want a parallel line. So my point I have, and the slope I'm going to use comes from right there. My slope is negative 3 over 2. Now, I just said that they gave you equations of lines so that you can find the slope. Well, I just found it. You know what? That means I do not need to look at the equation of the line given to me anymore. And you really should erase that or scribble it out, because a lot of students will still be distracted by the numbers in that equation even after they already found the slope that was in there. So make sure you don't look at it again. We have a point and a slope. Well, if we have a point and a slope, we're going to plug into point slope form, which is y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. And don't forget, this is where our numbers go for x1, y1, and m. So we have y minus the y from the point equals the slope, which is negative 3 over 2, times x minus the x of the point, which is 4. This is in point slope form. A lot of textbooks will not be happy, or teachers will be happy if you leave it in this form. So I'm going to distribute this through and put it in slope intercept form, which I will ask my students to do. Negative 3 halves times 1 is negative 3 halves x. Negative times negative is positive. 3 times 4 over 1, okay, because this is a fraction, so 3 times 4 is 12. And 12 divided by 2 is equal to 6, so plus 6. I need to take this negative 6. Anytime you move things over or under the equal sign, you have to do the opposite. So I'm going to add 6 to both sides and get y equals negative 3 over 2x plus 12. And I have the equation of my parallel line. All right, let's try another one. What if I want a line that is perpendicular to a point, and perpendicular through a point and perpendicular to another line? So let's say I want a line that is perpendicular to y equals 1/4 x minus 4, yes, and goes through the point of 2, 1. Well, now this equation I have given now is already in slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b. So, again, all you need to write the equation of a line is a point, we have that, and a slope. So my point is 2, 1, and my slope, well, my slope here is equal to 1/4, but I want a perpendicular slope, and perpendicular slopes are opposite reciprocals. So perpendicular to a slope of 1/4 is negative 4. Let me just take a second and explain why perpendicular slopes are opposite reciprocals. If I go up 1 and over 4 from the origin, just as an example now, I'm not trying to graph this line. Here is a line, here's a line representing the slope of 1/4. If I take a book here and use it to make a drawing that's perfectly, as close to perfect as I can, perpendicular and then count this off, what's the slope of this line? How do I get from this point to this point? Well, now I got to go down 1, 2, 3, 4 over 1. Well, when you go down or up, that's a form of rise. Over 1? Okay, so just a quick visual. I probably should have had the grid down, but a quick visual sketch of what perpendicular really means and why it's an opposite reciprocal, by counting off this as an example. Okay, at any rate, we have a point and a slope, and once again, we have y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1, which is going to be x minus 2. And there is our perpendicular line, which will then distribute this negative 4 through the parentheses And I'm just taking the step again to put this into slope-intercept. Negative times negative is positive. Add both sides by 1. And we get y is equal to negative 4x plus 9. Perpendicular line segment. Let me do another one that's a little bit tricky. I think I have a few minutes. I want to find the equation of a line that is through negative 1.5 and is perpendicular to the line x equals 4. This line is a very special case. X equals a number is a vertical line. Vertical lines have an undefined slope. They also do not have a y-intercept. So if you don't understand or have memorized the properties of vertical lines, this is going to be an impossible question. I asked for a perpendicular line segment. What's perpendicular to x equals 4? This line x equals 4. Perpendicular to a vertical line is a horizontal line. We're going to draw some kind of horizontal line. I'm going to start a drawing here. But I want my horizontal line to go through the point negative 1.5. Well, negative 1.5, let's do this in blue. Negative 1.5 is right here. Back 1 and up 5. So I want a line perpendicular to a vertical line going through that point. Well, if I draw a horizontal line through that point, that's perpendicular and that's horizontal. Horizontal lines have a slope of 0. And the equation, which is what the question is about, the equation of horizontal lines are y equals a number. Well, what number does this point go through or this point contain? The x is negative 1, the y is 5, and that's kind of like a special case. Horizontal and vertical lines, if you do not have those memorized, you're going to have trouble with those. Okay, I'm going to keep talking. Hopefully I run out of time. I want to do one more example. I want a line through 0, 4, and I want it to be parallel to a line with x-intercept of 7 and a y-intercept equal to 5. Or negative 5. Again, sort of a weird one, kind of not your typical problem you get out of a lot of textbooks with the x and y intercepts given. Can't look at it and just immediately tell what the slope is. We have a point, but we need a slope. So I need the slope of this weird line, it's not weird, but in the way it's given with the x and y intercepts. You might be able to get it, or just from the top of your head. Or, I like to, with geometry questions, especially when they're kind of tough, draw a picture. I have a line with an x-intercept of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I have a y-intercept of negative 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now that I have this drawn, I have a line whose slope is up 5 over 7. So, now that I have my point, now I've got my parallel slope of 5 over 7. Now, I've done a couple of examples completely through for you. And I'm running out of time, so I'm going to shortcut this a little bit. You see how this point has an x value of 0? Any point with an x value of 0 means you've not moved off the origin. You've just gone up 4 places. Well, if you've just gone up 4 places, you're still on the y-axis. And if you're on the y-axis, that means that this is the y-intercept. And if this is the y-intercept already, and we just drew a picture to find the slope, slope-intercept? I think that is y equals mx plus b. I can write this answer in slope-intercept form without having to do any extra work at all. And that is a big old fat bam! Have a great day.